The prosecution's closing arguments wrapped up today, summarizing the 45 witnesses that spoke against the singer. The jury was reminded of the graphic details of sexual and emotional abuse, describing how R. Kelly operated from a, quote, predator's handbook of isolation, coercion, humiliation, and manipulation of underage victims. The prosecution once again laying out how the victims endured controlling behavior by the singer, including being denied food, access to their families, and forced to have unwanted sex. Federal prosecutor Elizabeth Geddes trying to paint R. Kelly as the head of a criminal enterprise that recruited girls, boys, and young women for sex by using his fame and fortune to get what he wanted, meeting his victims inside shopping malls, arenas, and even a McDonald's. The prosecutor ended more than 6 hours of closing arguments by saying, quote, "It is time to hold the defendant responsible for the pain inflicted on each of his victims, Aaliyah, Stephanie, Sonia, Geronda, Jane, and Faith. It is now time for the defendant, Robert Kelly, to pay for his crimes. Convict him," end quote. The 9 counts against R. Kelly include a racketeering charge and 8 violations of the Mann Act for sex trafficking across state lines. Witness testimony could be a hint of the length of closing arguments. The prosecution offered 45 witnesses over a 3-week period. The defense had 5 people testify in less than 3 days. Legal analysts say closing arguments by the singer's defense team have one goal.
For the defense, remember, they just have to find one reasonable doubt, plant that seed of doubt in one juror, and guess what? You'll have a mistrial.